Have you ever wondered how it is to live in a Ukrainian deep village? We will explore this today in this video.
Imagine meeting as many beautiful traditional ladies as it takes until you meet the one. That's exactly what you can win right now. Just comment, subscribe and share. The winner will be announced live right here.
Hey guys, Anna here, heart of Match Guaranty, and today we have incredible tour in a real deep village house. I just want to mention that we are right now in Odessa region, Belgorod-Dnistrovsky district, in a village called Vilne. So in this village there is no pharmacy, there is no shops, there is no, basically nothing, just several streets and several houses. And people, imagine, live there whole year. So guys, as you can see, there is no roads as a normal situation in Ukraine, but for this village actually it's very good road, because sometimes you cannot even, like, not even drive, but cannot walk. I ask if we can film the house of one local woman who live here with her husband, and she will tell how it is to live here. Mariya nicely allow us to make excursion in her home, so she will show us how it is and tell us about how to live in the village.
В одну комнату я вас не пущу. Сегодня у мене дед трошечки.
Я поняла. So guys, we now at in front of Maria's house, and it's approximately 60 square meters, and the land where it's situated is approximately 10 acres, and then she has place where she can grow vegetables, it's additional 20 acres. The problem that many Ukrainian people have, they didn't do privatization, it means they have only rights for their house, but they don't have rights for their land. So basically at some point they can lose, you know, this house. That's why the approximate cost of this house to buy is from $3,000 to $4,000. It's food for goats for the all winter. This one very beautiful tree, it's for decoration of the house, called Ratana. Yeah, for beauty. It's a storage, it's where people, all Ukrainian people, they keep their food, they do preparation, also keep potato, all vegetables that they have from summer, they keep all year, come here. Most of Ukrainian people, they don't buy nothing in cans in the winter. They do everything by themselves in the summer, when it's high season. So they do in the cans, they do cucumbers, tomatoes, different vegetables, even salads. And they do it for like several years. So even if war starts, they can go here, live and have food for not 1 year, probably. So guys, let's look, check out the pets, local pets. You can see here chickens, geese. So Maria said that she grow them, cut them, eat and feed her family with these animals. And then what left, she sell at the market to have additional income that will allow to, you know, to survive for her family. Because it's not possible to live in Ukraine just on having pension from the government. Because the pension is $100, and we will find out later how much the bills for the house cost. So these grapes, it's called technical grapes, it's called Baku, and it's for wine. But Maria didn't do wine, so she just do juices, grapes juices. All village houses have many cats. Guys, come on to check out the garage. So now I will introduce you to the most popular transport in the village. It's a moped, you know. Almost all village people have it because it's very easy to use, very easy to get somewhere if you need. So let's check out winter kitchen, because most of Ukrainian houses, they have also summer kitchen, but this one kitchen that they use all year. this village very lucky because they have running water. And it's actually, as Mariya said, not very often they don't have water, maybe two, three times in a year. And as I find out, I never saw this before, I asked about hot water. It's electric, you just open it and it comes hot water. It's how Mariya cooks. She has a gas stove and she uses gas. But to get gas in the village, she has to drive her gas tank to the station to get a gas inside. And it costs 600 hryvnias, and it's very actually dangerous procedure. And then she has to keep this tank at home, because this 600 hryvnias of gas, it's enough for 2-3 months of cooking at the stove. As Mariya told me earlier, she lived not like really poor village life, but not also very rich. But it's something, wash machine, it's something very luxury, I can say, for the most houses in the village. It was gift from her daughter because she bought the biggest one for her. And now Mariya can use these things to make her life much easier. This one, the sound of the old fridge. So this is the kitchen table and it's where family has dinner. As you can see, a lot of Ukrainian houses as well as flats has pictures of saints, and they believe that God helped them in their life and protect their families. Imagine, this kitchen were built before revolution. So it's before 1916, so it's one century already. And another part of the building that we will check out now, it's more newer and should be fancy, more fancy. So let's check out how it looks like. So guys, many of Ukrainian houses, they have summer kitchen and winter kitchen. We just was at the winter because it has heating. But what's interesting, to get here, you have to go from the street. So now, to move into house, you have to go out. So in winter, imagine minus 20, you have to leave kitchen and go into house through street. So let's look at the main house. Come on guys, don't be shy. Ukrainian people are very hospitable. So this one, it's a main house. Let's start from the heating system. It's right here. They buy one time in a year black coal, 7,000 hryvnias it cost with delivery, and it's enough for whole winter. And it's actually heat the wall, and this wall connected two rooms, so it heats this room and this room, but doesn't go to the third bedroom. And how to heat one more bedroom? The same heater installed in kitchen where we were before. So they put coal there, and then this wall become warm, and it heats this room plus kitchen. So guys, this one bedroom number 2 with a lot of beds. If guests will come or relatives, they have place where they can stay. And this one, furniture from Soviet Union time, where you can find a lot similar furniture in many old flats and houses as well, even now. As you can see, also carpets on the wall, it makes the space more warmer where you sleep. And I remember when I was a small kid, we also had in our flat carpets on the wall. It's something very normal. Also on the floor, everywhere in Ukraine, in village houses, they all have carpets. It's very traditional for Ukrainian village. So guys, as you can see, old houses, they have like very thick walls, like 60 centimeters. It's built in old way that makes house very warm in the winter and very cold in summertime. And it's built from very ecological material, normally mud, can be bricks, and in very way that it can stay maybe for 100 years more. So it's bedroom number 1 where Mariya live. And as you can see, there is bed, some chairs, TV, no internet in this village, and also a lot of pictures of the family, relatives, especially when small children was. So they keep these nice memories of how they grow. It's two daughters. They live one in Russia now, and one in Sergeyevka, very close, only 10 kilometers from here. So guys, look at the wiring in the old village houses. It's very typical for Ukrainian houses, but they just don't have money to fix it. I asked Mariya how she survived on her pension. She said, oh, I even keep it and I help my daughter because she's single and she has three children. She lives 10 kilometers from here, but doesn't have husband. And the man she was divorced, he didn't pay any alimony. So it's actually very normal in Ukraine to hear stories like that when pensionist people, very old people, help their children in these difficult situations. So I asked Mariya, how did she find life in village? She said that basically if you have health, if you're young enough, because it takes a lot of time and effort and health, you know, to keep going things here. But she likes it because it's nature, it's fresh air and many things, but she's just not sure that if she enough have health to take care about this, all of that. But she said, I don't know how people in Ukraine, pensioner people, they survive in the city with doesn't have any additional income, because these animals that they is like additional pension for her, additional income for her that allow her to survive, because you know, as you know, our pensioner in Ukraine, they not supported by government, not protected. That's the reality. So guys, I hope you enjoy this video and you find many interesting things about deep Ukrainian village house. And write me in comments if you would want to have this experience and what you think about this video and would you like to see this kind of videos more. I did a video before about tour in upgrade of Soviet Union flat, and one of the guide wrote that it reminds him ghetto. So write me what it reminds to you, this house, because I think previous flat much more comfortable for to live. Anyway, it's a reality of Ukrainian life, how it is, and maybe it makes us all appreciate more what we have in our lives. I will wait for you in my upcoming videos.